This game is tea and is not suitable for kids.
It's still early in the afternoon. The blue sky is stretching all the way over to the horizon. Sunohara and I are walking, still wearing our uniforms. In front of us, Miyazawa in her uniform is walking next to the casually dressed man. From time to time, we're greeted by the suspecting looks of the passerbys, but I suppose that's to be expected.
Man as in the man. What more do you want?
After all, we should still be sitting in classes at this time of day. What is it?
Omae, nani ge ni inochi giri giri no tsunawatari shiteru yo na.
What are you talking about?
Boku sa, hiru yasumi no tochuu kara mado no soto ni ita nda.
So he saw me again.
Chinami ni, ano hito wa boku yori mae ni ita ze.
This guy's just spying on us. This is weird. Eh? Seriously? My feet slow down a little as I take a glance at the man walking beside Miyazawa.
What?
What is this guy? So he's seen everything. I wonder if I could make it back home in one piece today.
Oh, Yukine.
Arai-san.
Coming from another route, a man holding a flower calls out to Miyazawa. He isn't showing any of the cheerfulness I saw the other day. It's a dimmed greeting from both sides.
Yuki-san.
Kusakari-san.
What the heck? You're not interrupting me. Not at all. I like interacting with Twitch chat. Kusakari-san, what are you waiting to hear for us for? Uh-oh. We see all of these guys named Man. Yeah, I know. When Twitch streamers get big enough, the chat is just like face meltingly fast, and there's basically no interaction. That's kind of sad. I like being able to talk to people while I stream. The number of our companions increases as we keep going forward. Despite the brightness of their voices, I can sense the loneliness hidden somewhere in their expressions. Aww. So all these people were her brother's friends.
You're the man,
everyone's the man, basically. I definitely think we are out of place. Everyone who's gathered here are those who shared memories of her brother, and they're here to mourn him. What if Yukine is the man? That would be a twist. Not one that I would like. But I've never even met him. All I can do now is keep my mouth shut and sympathize with the crowd's atmosphere. Why did she even call me here? Because she likes us. Why did she ask me to do that embracing spell? I have a convenient interpretation for everything, but in the end, it's just that, my own interpretation. If it's wrong, then continuing to push forward would just turn me into an excessively self-conscious clown. No, not that word. Oh, wow. New BG. Several people have already gathered in front of the grave even before our arrival. They all greet Miyazawa in the same manner. Sunohara and I stand off at a distance and watch. They are now putting their offerings before the gravestone, and one by one, they start to report on their present lives. I'm going to a professional school now. With that, an incense stick is put down. Actually, I've become a father. I'm getting married soon. Another stick. I found a job. It's just labor, but I'm feeling very satisfied. And another stick. In the end, you never let me take my revenge. One after another. I wanted to play around with you more. The white smoke drifts away toward the sky.
Tomoya-san.
Hmm? What is it?
これを...
She hands me a lit incense stick.
お兄さんに...
You know I will. She takes my hand and walks to the grave. The incense holder placed in front of the perfectly cleaned gravestone is already tightly packed with everyone's offerings. Even so, I somehow managed to put mine in without breaking anything. I put my hands together and close my eyes. There's only one thing I can report to him. Your sister. She's still doing her best. Even with all these people adoring her, she never goes easy on herself. And she keeps living on so strongly, so straightforward.
話を聞いてくれますか?
I open my eyes in surprise upon hearing her voice. You're not a fan of this, because the relationship is a bit forced. Yeah, I can see that. You don't think Yukine really needs someone like that right now? Yeah, I can agree with that, for sure. Did she say that to me alone, or did she mean it to be heard by everyone here? The only thing I know is she's gotten the attention of all the attendees. Yes. I didn't want to interrupt. Don't talk on it.
いつも両親と喧嘩をしていました。家はとても厳しく私たち二人を育てようとしましたので、それにずっと不満を覚えていたんです。どうして親の決めた道を歩んでいかなくてはならないのか。もっと自由でもいいはず。道はいくらだってあるはずなんだから。
I can't listen to it again. I know.
そう、反発していたんです。私は親の言いつけを守って習い事をして勉強をして育ちました。兄は大きくなるにつれ、乱暴に。
I don't think she's part of the Yakuza.
私は大きくなるにつれ礼儀正しくまるで鏡合わせのように育っていったんです。 そんな二人でしたが、私と兄はとても仲良しでした。恋人同士みたいに。そして兄は高校に入るとたくさんの友達ができて、家に帰ってこなくなりました。It
was way worse. Me accidentally interrupting people speaking was way worse in the real route. Because she talks so slowly, it takes like 4 second gaps between her sentences sometimes. It got crazy. At the end, like, it was like every sentence I was accidentally interrupting.
Oh
no, not a delinquent.
でも、たまに会う兄は生き生きとしていました。家は最悪だけど、外は楽しくて仕方がないと、そう言っていました。 仲間がたくさんできたんです。兄には世間からどう言われようとも、兄は彼らを誇りに思ってたんです。私は兄の友達には会いませんでした。当時の私は本当に普通の女の子で、そういう方たちが、兄は自分で自分の居場所を見つけて気ままに暮らしていたんです。
Best part about Ryo's voice actress, she voices one of your favorite female protagonists ever in a video game. Really? Which one?
両親と会うと喧嘩の種を作って出て行くようになっていました。Estelle
from Legend of Heroes trails in the sky. Interesting.
だから兄は両親とも会わないようにして暮らし始めました。 でも、私だけには会いに来てくれました。そして、お土産にお菓子をたくさん持ってきてくれました。家にいては食べられないものばかりでした。虫歯になるほど食べました。二人で過ごす時間は、とても楽しいものでした。私が作ったお弁当を、二人で食べたり、兄の膝枕で眠ったり、 とても楽しくて、そして安心できました。でも、そんな時間も長く続きませんでした。兄は事故で帰らぬ人となってしまいました。その時も仲間の誰かをかばったんだそうです。両親はあんな奴らと一緒にいたからだと、そう嘆きました。
That's terrible.
その時の私にはよくわかりませんでした。何が正しかったのか。
If this route was just about becoming friends with Yukine, you'd be fine with it. You feel like she would have told you this even if they became just friends. Yeah, I agree with that.
ただ、兄は立派だったと思いました。
Not every route has to be a romantic one. The Mei Sunohara route was thankfully not a romantic route, and it was way better because of that.
葬儀には 兄のお友達がたくさん訪れました。色とりどりの格好で態度も悪くて、それでも兄の前でだけは真剣な目をしてました。泣いてる人もいました。彼らは本当に兄と深い友情で結ばれた仲間だったんです。だから私は勇気を持って声をかけました。宮沢和人の妹ですって。
カズト、
少しだけ話をしました。そして私は彼らが失ったものの大きさを知りました。そして大好きな兄と共に生きてくれた人たちのその胸に開いてしまった穴を埋めたいってその時思いました。だってその人たちはみんな兄と似ていたからです。
Oh, and Masai's route was acceptable because it was mostly about Masai, like telling her that someone can love her for who she really is at this point in time. She actually needed it. Yeah, there was honestly very little in the Masai route about Masai and Tomoya being romantically involved, because like you can even interpret that as like she isn't interested in Tomoya, but she might move on from her childhood love in the future. So I think that they did that well. I thought the Masai route like did not wrap up half of the veins that it should have.
向こう水で、乱暴で、素直じゃなくて、そして他人のために無謀になれるほど優しい人たち。私には同じに見えたんです。でも、それは思っていた以上に困難なことでした。だって、私は普通の女の子で。
Like they didn't, the Masai route, they really didn't reveal who the heck the guy pretending to be Shima was. Like he turned into a cat in the end, but like who was he before that? Yeah, and I got the true ending in the Tomoyo route for that. It also doesn't explain how he was able to turn into a cat. Or, like... it's just like, all of the stuff just came out of nowhere at the end with very little explanation.
それ以上の力を持たない無力な存在でしたから。私は兄がいた場所に通いました。そしていろんな人に話をして回りました。何度も突き放されたりしました。
Oh, so are all of these guys not like crushing on her, but like are really just like she's a good friend, like she's basically who our friend who we used to have. Key visual novels like this stuff, yeah, but like the weird stuff.
怖い思いもしました。
Oh! There is a CG. It's like a little drawing of her. For the old Miyazawa, those places must have been like a whole other world. What a fragile creature she must have been. How I wish I could have known her then. I would have run to her side to be with her.
冬になると、みんなの分の手袋を編んでプレゼントしました。冷え込む夜には、温かいおしるこを振る舞いました。みんなには甘すぎて不評でしたけど、クリスマスになると手作りのケーキを配って食べてもらいました。私は一人だけサンタの格好で浮いちゃっていましたけど、それでもみんな食べてくれました。話に相槌を打ってくれるようになって、
that's really cute. Aw, that's adorable. The older you get, the more of this stuff hits you. Yeah, for sure.
ごちそうさまって食べた後に言ってくれるようになって。
I know there's an anime adaptation of this, and basically what I've heard is it's like, it's a really emotional anime, and then once you're an adult, and especially once you're a parent, it will wreck you, is basically what I've heard.
また来たのかって。声をかけてくれるようになって。
Aww.
まってくれるようになりました。
Which one do I use as the thumbnail? These are the hard decisions I have to make in life.
それはとても暖かい。
It's already reckon you and you're 24? I'm 24 too! Same! I turned 24 in June. And man, it feels weird to say that.
そこはいつしか私にとって心が休まる場所になっていたんです。
I've got a heart of pure stone, though. It's gonna take a lot to make me cry. Perhaps tired from the long speech, Miyazawa starts closing her eyes. Or maybe she's trying to redraw the kindness-filled scenery on the back of her eyelids. But for what reason? It's right there before her the moment she opens her eyes.It's right here.
私は今、たくさんの仲間に支えられているんです。
So many fun. Why is it like every route is like no CGs, then at the end it's like 20 CGs? I feel like she's compressed everything into those few words. The life she's been devoted to until this very day. We are old like that teacher of theirs. Not that old. Are you talking about Masai? We're about Masai's age.Oh, wait, oh, or are you talking about the, old guy with the mustache? Oh, yeah, he was cool. She got, like, 4 CGs in the span of 5 minutes, yeah. I see. So you're all right now. Pretty much.To give support, to be supported. It all goes round and round in circles. At some point, a lot of people started to gather around her. I guess I'm just one of them. I squint against the blazing sun. And from the sky at this exact moment, a white light is falling down, drifting above my head. Jesus is coming? Then it just stays there, as if watching over Miyazawa and her friends. I try extending my arm toward it. Whoa!Are we actually getting an explanation on this? Okay, I don't think that's Jesus. The ball of light lands softly on my arm and instantly vanishes as if absorbed into my hand. What the heck? Are we actually going to get an explanation on this? The thing you like about this route, Miyazawa, is a really established, is an already established character, and she's teaching you. Yeah, very true.From there, a warm sensation spreads throughout my body. I don't know why, but I feel like this must be how she's feeling right now. I tend to really like the routes where, like, you've got two people, they both have their flaws, and then, like, if it's a romantic pairing, like, they help each other for their flaws, and they both grow as characters. That's what I really like. And that's also generally closer to what, it's like in the real world.But no one is saying a word in return. She just stands there, each holding a flower in their hand. I don't know what memory is recurring in their mind at this moment, but I do have one thing in common with them. In that case, do you want me to do a spell that will get everyone hyped up? An idea pops up in my head. I can guarantee you everyone here is going to make an uproar. Then, please excuse me. Whoa! Oh! Another CG! What the heck? How do I choose? How? I pull her slender body towards closer with my arms, and I press my lips on hers. Very soon now, the inevitable war will break out. The thought runs through my brain. Making this girl fall for me.It's going to be truly, literally, a suicide mission. This is actually the bad ending. This is how he dies. I know! Wait, that's how it ends? Wait a second, that's how it ends? It ends, we kiss her, then we die.5 seconds later, he gets punched. Basically, that
That's a route that literally just ends. Kind of like Masai's. Yeah, I felt bad that Tomoyo literally only got 4 CGs. Two of them weren't until later. Actually, I guess technically 5. And 3 of them you didn't get till the very end. Like, I wanted a CG of her beating up the bikers. Well, now this, but at least Tomoyo got a separate game. Yeah, I saw that. She apparently does have her own game called, like, it's not even like part of the side stories. It's like Tomoyo's Wonderful Life. Thoughts on the Yukine route? Okay. I definitely like it way less than my sister did. Like, my sister was like, this is the best route, you have to do it. I'm like, it was good. Definitely not one of my favorites, but okay. I felt like Yukine was a little bland as a character. Like, it's like her personality, she's really nice. That was kind of her personality. I definitely like her backstory. I really like all of the delinquents who just like kind of break in and hang out with her. That was a really cool plot point. I wish that, like, either she was in the Yakuza or, like, her family was part of the Yakuza. Because, like, they kind of were hinting towards that at the start of the route. That would have been way more interesting, I think. I'm not sure how that would have worked. Oh, well, Marty, since you're going to see the VOD, you can probably leave a comment why you like this route so much. Because she hasn't actually played the VN. She only saw the anime. And they obviously shorten all of the routes in the anime. That was still very enjoyable. Oh, bonus scene. It's the usual reference room again today. Okay, so we didn't die. The air still has a hint of the scent of pilaf. My eyes are wandering freely outside the window as I'm enjoying this hot cup of coffee. Miyazawa's sitting next to me, reading her spellbook. As for Sunohara, maybe they're about to explain this. They never really explain why she has the spellbook, what the heck the spellbook is, and why the stuff in there actually works. That was really weird. Like, all of a sudden, actual magic exists in the game, in the world. Maybe they did explain it, but I just skipped over it. I don't know. Explanation? As for Sunohara... Explanation. It is Japan. Deal with it. That's not a... Okay, it doesn't have a satisfactory explanation. use back! You know what? I already forgot about you. Even though I met him and, like, had the whole thing with him in this stream, I already forgot about him, even though it was only, like, 2 hours ago. He didn't really play a huge role in the route either. You expect too much from life. I am an optimistic pessimist. I hope for the best, and I plan for the worst. He's the type who loves to be toyed with. That is a pathetically unmanly thing to say in front of a kid. More than that, you, what about school? Does your school have a founding memorial day every week? He just said that without a millisecond of hesitation. The kid's gotten tough. Ooh, he should do the get locked in the PE shed with a girl spell again. Ooh, use it on him and Tomoyo. Alright, he's already going to screw up with step one. Why would I help you make me more compatible with you? Ignoring my complaint, Sunohara keeps walking until he's right in front of me. He then casually puts his hands on my shoulders.
Can I punch him now?
それで次は。
相手に目を閉じてもらいます。
Which route am I going to do next? I don't know. Once we are done with the epilogue, I will talk more about that.
だってさ。
I don't like where this is going. Regardless, I follow the instruction and close my eyes while imagining how the two of us would look to a third person.
そして自分も目を閉じます。そのまま顔を前に移動させて。
I can feel the air touching my face. There's this weird pressure coming from the front, triggering an unpleasant feeling. What is happening? The sound of me as I was flipping the pages reaches my ears clearly.
目を閉じたまま上手にキスができ
る。Get out of here. Hold on, what? I hastily open my eyes, but Tsunohara's face is already approaching. Holy shit! By reflex, I pull my head down and smash my forehead right into the middle of Tsunohara's face. Tsunohara is blown away facing the ceiling. The blood coming from his nose makes a red arc in the air. Wow. You would recommend Cape to get it out of the way. I have no clue who the heck that is. But okay. That was 1 second away from... Still lying on the floor, Tsunohara is groaning, his body trembling. Read the whole recipe before starting, because you might not have all the ingredients. Tsunohara screams as he jerks up from the floor, still crying. Duh! There was this thwack sound when it hit.
なんか目の奥の方でチカチカするよ。
Something's sparkling. His word makes me gaze at my hand. That thing felt soft. No, more like warm and soft.
どうしました?
Well, it was during the visit to your brother's grave. There was this ball of light flying above my head. Yes! That thing. I wonder if anyone else saw it.
そういやお前。
Yeah, that. I stretched my hand to that light. You saw it too, didn't you?
いや、何か取ろうとしてるようには見えたけど、何もなかったから、何してんだろうって思ってた。
Okay, so the goal of most route orders is to gradually spend more and more time with Nagisa, and Cape's route is one of the more, no, I don't hang out with her yet, if that makes sense. Okay. Okay. No, I hear ya. It was there, a ball of light. Please explain this to me. Please explain the ball of light. Someone's spirit. It can't be that. I got one for Kyo and she's not dead. What are you talking about? It fell down and vanished into my hand.
取り憑かれてるよこいつ。今喋ってるのも岡崎じゃない、レイコンだ。
Stop being ridiculous, will you?
じゃあ証明してみろよ。
Okay, my kick hits him in the solar plexus. Wow.
その容赦のなさ。確かに岡崎だ。きっとレイコンの方がまだ優しいの。
Yep, true.I also don't know who Kotomi is. Tsunohara drops face down onto the table.
大丈夫でしょうか、Tsunohara さん?
Yeah, just leave him. This is like our everyday snack time for us.
そうですか。
Miyazawa puts a folded towel under Tsunohara's head, probably for him to use as a pillow. Then she turns to me. And please don't reveal who these characters are.
光のことですが。
Yeah?
昔はよく見られたそうですよ。
Seriously?
はい。ですので、トモヤさんの言ってることは本当のことだと思いますよ。
Do you know what it was?
ここにはこの町の風土記もいくつか収められています。そこに伝承としてそのようなもののことが書かれていました。
Folk tales of the balls of light.
読んでみますか?
Nah, reading isn't my thing. I want to hear it from you.
はい。 言っても詳しいことは何一つ書かれていません。植物の種子につく冠毛だとか精霊の一種だとかあるのは憶測だけです。
Now there's gotta be more to it than that, because fake Shima had an orb of light and he was gonna use that to grant Masai's wish. So it's not just a seed.
ただ一つ共通することは、いつからかそれは幸せの象徴とされていたということです。
Happiness, huh?
いいことがあったときに見かけることが多かったそうです。
Oh, is it like getting the good endings will always get you a light orb?
幸せな風景を見つけ、まるでそれを見守るようにそこにふわふわと浮いていたそうです。
It was the same for me. The scenery back then was exactly the symbol of Miyazawa's current happiness. I can't help gazing down at my hand again.But nothing that reminds me of the white light can be seen anymore.
でも、それはあくまで伝承で、今ではその存在を信じる人はいません。なぜなら、誰も見たことがないからです。
But I did.
はい、そうですね。だから、私は信じますよ。
This is becoming an interesting mystery. I see.She has no idea how much she, what she just said means to me. But then, why was I the only one who saw it?
そこまではわかりません。もしかすると、トモヤさんは特別なのかもしれませんね。いえ、違いますね。特別なのは私たちの方です。昔の人はそれを見ることができたんですから。
Then how come we can't see them anymore?
それは人の心が変わってしまったからではないでしょうか。もっとこの街を慈しむような心が必要なのかもしれません。
Tomoya hates this town. That's like one of the opening lines.
もっと街とつながりを持って暮らしていたなら、今でも多くの人が見ることができたのかもしれません。
Oh, is that it? Where he's like, I don't ever want to leave for some reason, even though I hate it. That's strange.
昔と比べて変わってしまったこと。それは人が人だけで生きていると思い出したことですから。
Egotism, is that it? Then it's the same for me. In the first place, I really hate this town. Yeah!
そうなんですか?
Yeah.Putting Sunohara aside, it's you, not me, who should be able to see them.
では、どうしてなんでしょうね?
Let's stop with the thinking. But there's one thing I have to admit. I don't hate this town as much as I used to. All thanks to a certain someone. Aww. That's cute. So I had achievement unlocked, a gentle scenery.And here comes the inevitable Steam achievement, gentle scenery. Nice! Alright, so we got another light orb, and we got Yukine's portrait here. That's a nice one. Yeah. So, I'm gonna take a quick break, gotta use the bathroom. I'll be right back, like, 5 minutes probably. And then we can talk about the next route. So, hang in tight, see you guys in a few minutes.